You gotta redeem her after this, though.
Drink at
church.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Drink at church.
I've been lucky enough to travel overseas, play for a minimum in a uniform, on 9 different trips, in 17 countries.
Come on, baby. They give us grape juice.
I'm so proud of those shows. It's been some of the best memories of my entire life, happened on those trips. And on this one trip, we went to the Middle East, and while we were there, they sent us on a little side mission to this country in Africa that's called Djibouti. Djibouti is right next door to Somalia and Ethiopia. It's a really bad neighborhood. Horrible place to be deployed. So, but I found in my travels, the worse the place to be deployed, the better the show turns out. Because those folks are just dying for any sort of distraction. So while we were there, we said, you know, that Djibouti, that's a funny word. We should write a funny song for these guys, try to make them laugh. And so, the day of the show, we sat down on the bunk bed there in the tent. And we wrote this here song, thinking we would never play it again. We're like, it'll be funny here in Djibouti, but when we get back home, it won't be funny. Well, this song just turned 11. And still get requests. She said, I really don't think I'd like it all that much in Djibouti. I said, no, I heard that it was pretty good in Djibouti. Said, but all my girlfriends said they hated it in Djibouti. I said, no, babe, the guy that cuts my hair said he loves it in Djibouti. You don't ever need no raincoat in Djibouti. Ain't gotta worry about no kids. Not in Djibouti. She said, but I heard that it was hot and dirty and nasty in Djibouti. I said, well, how bad could it be? You know everybody does it in Djibouti. You got your airmen in Djibouti. You got them soldiers in Djibouti. You got them jarheads in Djibouti. You got the seamen. You know that's the Navy. One hot and steamy night, I went and I big and I pleaded, but I was trying to change her mind. So I gave her my beer cart, she slammed three tall boys down. We found ourselves a bunker, and I finally got her turned around. Well, now she says she loves it in Djibouti. She wants it all the time in Djibouti. I walked to her. I just ain't enough in Djibouti. She wants me to re-up in Djibouti. She likes airmen in Djibouti. She likes them soldiers in Djibouti. She likes them jarheads in Djibouti. She likes the seamen. Now there is a new chapter to the Djibouti story. Now my kids live up in Idaho, up in this place called Sandpoint, Idaho. It's gorgeous up there. It's near Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. They got a lake and a ski resort up there. It's beautiful. But every time we go up to Sandpoint, we got to drive to this little town. It's called Athol, Idaho. And it's spelled A-T-H-O-L. And every time I drive through there, I think, what an unfortunate name for a town. Who would want to be from a place called Athol? Well, as fate would have it, I was doing a show in North Idaho. When who should I meet but the mayor of Athol? Her name is Darla, and she's a little spitfire. She's a little, like, you know, 5 foot tall blonde lady. She said, yeah, I'm the mayor of Athol. I know, we're the butt of a lot of jokes. She said, you know what they call people from our town? They call us assholes. She said, we can't even have a sports team up there. You know why? Because nobody wants to root for the Athol Raiders. Or the Athol Pirates. And certainly not the Athol Packers. considering changing the name of the town. I said, really, what would you change it to, darling? She said, well, we're thinking about anus. But a couple summers ago, we got invited to go up there and play a festival they have. It's called Asshole Days. We really did it for one reason and one reason only. We're hoping that maybe in the local paper up there, the headline would read, Djibouti songwriter packs him in an apple. Well, we didn't get the headline in the paper, but we did get invited back for Asshole Days number two. She likes a canine in Djibouti. She likes them privates in Djibouti. She likes her grunts in Djibouti. She got colonels in Djibouti. Show one night, this guy said, man, you left out the most obvious one. I said, what do you mean? He said, you forgot to mention rear admirals in Djibouti. And then the guy knew, he said, man, I knew a guy one time. His name was Rear Admiral Colin Hunter. I got one more development about this song. This song just keeps getting longer and longer, man. Last summer, Coley and I were doing a gig in Missouri, and we were driving down the highway out there, Highway 44, and we saw this billboard out there for this place. It's called the Uranus Fudge Factory. It's in Uranus, Missouri, off of the historic Route 66. And I was like, we got to pull over for this, because on the billboard it said, the best fudge is packed in Uranus. And I was like, I don't care about the fudge, I just want the t-shirt. So we rolled in there, we got the fudge, got the t-shirt. As we were walking out the door, they said, thank you for picking Uranus. You know it's hot in Djibouti, and it's dirty in Djibouti. It's pretty nasty in Djibouti, but I like it in Djibouti. Oh. Not me personally, you know what I'm saying? I always say it's better to give than to receive. That's the way it comes to Djibouti. But the best thing about it all, the best thing about it all is, well,